Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to this brand new series presented by Continental with the wonderful name, The Garage. My name is Chris Brow, and I have the honor, the pleasure to be your host for the next episodes, talking about some exciting innovations, new products, new technologies with the experts in the field from Continental. And I gotta tell you, I'm really happy to be here today on the one side, but also kind of anxious on the other, feel a certain amount of anxiety because I had a dentist appointment last week. I was in pain till yesterday. And like I said, I feel good today, but my first guest seems to be a doctor. He's actually an application engineer at Continental, and he goes by the name of Patrick Raffla. Welcome, Patrick.
Hey, Chris.
How are you doing today?
I'm fine. How about you?
Like I said before, I'm doing pretty good, but seeing you in that outfit.
Chris, I'm not a doctor. As you said, I'm an application engineer. I'm working for Continental in the conveyor belt group, and I design conveyor belts as well as inspection and monitoring systems.
Okay, but maybe even though you're not a doctor, maybe you can tell me how to avoid going to the dentist in the future?
Medical prevention, this is the key word. You know, it is very important to have checkups regularly. Maybe the reason for your pain could have been recognized at an early stadium?
Probably, yeah, you're probably right. But does that mean you do the same kind of prevention with your conveyor belts?
Yes, we do. But we name it predictive maintenance. Mm-hmm. Our conveyor belts are running in very rough areas. Yeah, in Scandinavia at minus 40 degrees Celsius or in the desert at plus 50 degrees Celsius.
Right.
Yeah, the belts convey materials, chemicals underground, or hard rock like iron ore in the Andes in South America. So everything harms the belt.
So you can kind of compare it to the skin of the human being, right?
Yeah, the sun is a very good example, yeah? It makes the conveyor belt porous.
But unlike us humans, the conveyor belt doesn't have to go to the doctor.
No, they don't.
Lucky for them. I was thinking, when I look at the scanner, it would be perfect if we would have a device like this to scan our body surface from head to toe, and for the scanner then to tell us exactly what we can expect.
This is exactly what we are doing with our conveyor belts.
Really?
Yes. And today I brought one example of our belts with me. So let's have a look and check it out. Would you like to be my assistant?
Yeah, why not? I always wanted to wear one of these. Makes me feel like George Clooney. So what do I do?
So please roll the belt out. So here you can see one of our smallest belts. Normally in the mining industry, we have belts that are 2 to 3 meters wide, 10 to 15 kilometers long. And what you can see here in the inside of the belt, we have steel cords. Mm. This is the carcass, yeah, which is responsible for the pulling force to move the belt. Next to the belt, I have some sensors with me that we are using to monitor and to inspect the conveyor belt in order to do predictive maintenance. So first of all, I show you an optical sensor that is working with laser line technology.
Mm-hmm.
Very similar to your device here.
Okay.
And we are using this in order to scan the surface and find and measure all kind of cover damages, like cracks and grooves. Everything washes on the surface of the belt. I have another sensor with me. This is for the inside. And this one is working with magnetic fields.
Mm-hmm.
So it can detect cord damages or splice damage. So let's move the belt over the sensor and we will see what kind of data will come out. So here you can see the data. Yeah? You can see in the information how many cords are affected in this area and what is the position and the amount of the failure.
Pretty cool. So that means that basically with these two devices, you can actually avoid illnesses of your products.
The availability of a conveyor is directly linked to the material.
Mm-hmm.
No conveyor belt, no material, no material, no money.
Mm-hmm.
And this is very important for our customers that the belt lives as long as possible.
So that sounds great. And you know what? I was thinking maybe you can get in contact with my dentist and maybe you could develop something similar for human beings, huh?
Chris, I am already in contact with your doctor. And by the way, this is his present for your last visit.
No way. That is awesome. That's what I call customer service. Thank you very much if you happen to watch. And I need one picture from you, Patrick.
Oh, yeah.
Have you ever heard of a selfie?
Of course.
Probably. 3, 2, 1, smile. Thank you very much, Patrick.
Thank you, too. It was a pleasure to be here.
It was a pleasure having you. I hope to see you again soon, and I hope to see you for the next episode of The Garage. Until then, take good care. See you again then. Bye-bye.